Philippine senators continue to dig into the real identity of suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian reveals Go's brother, Wesley Leal Go, has the same fingerprints as Chinese national Go Xiangdan. Like Go, her siblings have been subpoenaed to attend the Senate hearing on July 10. But for Gatchalian, the Bamban mayor cannot be a star witness in the POGUS investigation.
Hindi ko kasi nakikitang least guilty siya dahil doon sa mga dokumento na nakita namin, siya yung nag-apply. In fact, siya yung nag-trigger para makapasok itong POGO hub sa Bamban.
Meanwhile, investigators also found the existence of a third Alice Go, but her fingerprint did not match with that of the mayor, even if they had the same birthday and birthplace. The NBI is now offering a reward to anyone who can give information on the whereabouts of the third woman.
Maaring may instruction na kumuha ka ng clearance under this name. Eh, itong taon na to ay hindi existent ito. Walang Alice Go na ganito iturang mukha. Pero kung may makakapagturo, siguro makakuha ko ng mga 50,000 doon sa aming confidential fund. Pwede.
Pwede.
Yes, because we are investigating something eh.
The National Security Council allays fears over a reported imminent missile attack by China. The NSC says it is not aware of any security threat mentioned by the president's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos. It also plans to reach out to the senator to get more information about her statement. Senator Marcos earlier claimed 25 areas in the country could be targeted by China's hypersonic missiles as tensions grow in the West Philippine Sea. The Armed Forces of the Philippines also seeking to coordinate with the senator, saying it takes such concerns seriously. The White House keeping tabs on the reported seizure of a Taiwanese fishing boat by China. In a further escalation of tensions, Taiwan's Coast Guard said Chinese officials boarded and seized a squid fishing boat late Tuesday, taking it to a Chinese port. The boat was operating during China's no-fishing period with five fishermen on board, including three Indonesians. Taipei tried to ask for the release of the fishermen, but Beijing warned it not to interfere. Taiwan's ships backed off to avoid a conflict.
So on the fish boat, we're obviously closely monitoring the incident, so we're going to continue to do that.
Has U.S. reached out to Japan and Taiwan offer support over those incidents?
Well, I don't have any calls, obviously, to speak to at this time, but we encourage both sides to maintain open lines of communication so they can get to a resolution here, and that's what we call for.
China views Taiwan as its own territory. It has ramped up pressure on Taipei since President Lai Ching-te took office, a man Beijing accuses of being a separatist. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department looking into reports of an alleged data breach. Cybersecurity advocacy group Deep Web Connect claimed sensitive data from the DFA, including emails, are now being sold online. The breach allegedly happened last month, and the hacker may still have access to the agency's email systems. The DFA says it is coordinating with the ICT department to investigate the matter. A legislative inquiry into the hefty price tag of the new Philippine Senate building leads to a tense exchange between two senators who belong to rival political clans. This story from Willard Cheng.
In the first hearing of the Senate Committee on Accounts on the new Senate building, its new chair, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, sought to scrutinize its costs following a review ordered by Senate President Francis Escudero. The DPWH admitted no consultations were made with the Senate prior to the detailed architectural and engineering design or DAED. Cayetano said this was a deviation from standard procedure, reason for changes that have to be made, hence the ballooning cost that included extension of time and redesign fees.
How many consultations did you have with the Senate employees?
None, sir.
None. How many consultations with the 24 senators?
We do not have a consultation.
If you made all the revisions before DAEB, may VO ba yan at merong bang bayad? Wala. Pati EOT. Wala, di ba? Before DAEB, di ba? Oh, pero hindi nyo kinausap ang Senado before DAEB eh. Kinausap nyo after DAEB eh. That's why nagka-VO ng 800 million. That's why nagka-EOT ka ng napakalalaki.
DPWH Senior Undersecretary Emil Sadain apologized after Cayetano questioned his statement in a media interview. The total funding for the project has not reached 23 billion pesos, the amount first mentioned by Senate President Francis Escudero.
I stand corrected, Mr. Chair, and we seek apology for that figure.
Senator Nancy Binay arrived later, insisting the amount of 23 billion pesos is nowhere to be found on documents from DPWH.
So tama po na on your documentation, there's no such thing as 23 billion for DPWH. So I think you, Sac Sadain, hindi niyo po kailangan mag-apologize.
Sorry, ito yung presentation nila. Nandiyan yung 21.7 billion. If you add the land cost, it's 23 billion. But this was submitted by them.
The exchange between Binay and Cayetano became heated as Cayetano referred to Binay's statement on an unnamed senator, allegedly backstabbing her, and when she referred to politics and the Makati-Taguig feud as a possible motivation.
Hindi po ako nagugulo, Mr. Chairman.
Sige,
sa pagkasa po pala, magulo mo na yung issue.
Ma'am, hindi magulo yung issue. Ang linaw-linaw ng issue, 23 billion galing sa staff mo. Ikaw yung pumupunta sa media, sa radyo, kung ano-anong paninira, kung ano sinasabi mo sa akin. Sabi mo, may sumasaksak sa likod mo. Di kasuhan mo ng attempted murder. Sino ba sumasaksak sa likod mo? Wala akong alam doon.
Sinabi ko ba na ang Peter Cayetano ang sumasaksak sa akin? Parang... Di ba sabi nila yung pag nagre-react ng ganyan, baka guilty.
Ma'am, basta sasabihin ko sa iyo, Lourdes ang pangalan mo, hindi Marites. Kaya ayusin natin to, nakakahiya na.
Hindi po tayo Marites, Mr. Chairman.
Binay later walked out after making her point.
On your end, DPWH, nag-i-exist ba sa documents nyo yung amount na 23 billion? Yusek?
There is none, Mr. Chair.
Oh, no. Thank you.
Sorry. Ma'am,
there is none.
Order. Paulit.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I make my point. There's no such thing as 23 billion.
Paulit ulit kanina pa na 21.7 billion. Kabuang Kanaday. Tapusin natin na maayos to. Senado to ng Pilipinas. Hindi to palengke.
Before this, Binay found an ally in Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III, who also questioned the 23 billion figure mentioned by Escudero.
I hope na itong issue na ito hindi nahaluan ng politika. Because it's unfair to the former chairperson of the Committee on Accounts. Walang compensation yun, ha? Wala namang bayad yun to be chair of the Committee on Accounts. Well, additional responsibility lang yun eh. Tapos kung ang ending ay may intriga ka pa, it's unfair to her.
The committee is set to schedule another hearing. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
Soon after the hearing, Senator Binay accused Cayetano of gaslighting and grandstanding, saying he won't let her and the Public Works Department speak if he doesn't like their statements. The Philippine Education Department assures the public preparations for the opening of classes will not be affected by the leadership change in the agency. Senator Sonny Angara is set to take the helm of the DepEd on July 19, just a week before the July 29 opening of classes. DepEd Undersecretary Michael Poa says enrollment activities and preparations are underway. A meeting between Angara and outgoing DepEd Secretary Vice President Sara Duterte is also being set.
Ang mangyayari is, syempre, we are still preparing everything para pag upupo ng incoming secretary ay hindi na siya mahihirapan, no? Na smooth na, of course, without prejudice dun sa bagong direksyon na isiset niya. But at least pagdating sa school opening, pre-prepare na po natin lahat para nga po maging seamless yung transition.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Anna Clauden Jorda. Hi, Anna.
Yes, good morning, Bettina. The Intertropical Convergence Zone, or ITCZ, will continue to bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Palawan. While the easterlies will also bring scattered rain showers or light to moderate to the times heavy rains over Caraga and Davao region. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers mostly in the afternoon or in the evening due to easterlies and the localized thunderstorms. Currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance or LPA that may affect the country for the next 3 to 5 days. And the temperature range here in Metro Manila will be around 25 to 34 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Claren. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna.